eyes on you. Rig this whole mountain with cameras. The center's up ahead. I'm crawling with Peggy's. Be careful. Like I said before, if they spot you, they'll kill our people. So keep out of sight. There's a drain pipe nearby you can use to sneak up on them.
Devil's Drop. You gotta get the Devil's Drop.
If you leave me here,
please don't tell anyone I got caught like that.
There were more of us.
Help us get away.
I like flash from my eyes there. Save our guys at Devil's Drop. Please.
Careful. I owe you more than you can imagine. They got two whitetails in Hawkeye Tunnel.
Yep, they took two of our people up to Devil's Drop. Jacob's on the warpath trying to find a wolf's den. If the Peggies find us, we don't stand a chance. But if our guys don't give up the location, they'll be tossed off that cliff. All last, Step. Devil's Drop's to the south of you. Just inside the tunnel. Careful now. Roadblock up ahead. Shit. Looks like they took the whole tunnel. If you're crazy, take the front. If you're smart, head up top. Thank you. is accounted for. That's the Whitetail way, Depp. Helping us take care of our own is gonna have a big impact on morale. Maybe even get some more folks to join up, too. Shit. I knew Tammy was wrong about you. Congratulations. You're one of us now. If you got time, I got more work. Come see me in the wolf's den when you're ready.
Bud, over here.
Outstanding work, Depp.
Have you seen all
We're gonna
the
take this goddamn mountain back from Jacob. I know it. Picking up a lot of angry chatter from the cult. They're calling in chopper convoys to patrol for whitetails. Keep your head on a swivel and an eye to the sky.
Thank you so much.
There's a lot more of them out there, Depp. If you come across any others, you rescue them, too. Don't let those goddamn Peggies take any more good folk.
Cheeseburger is still loose. make the best of what we've got.
Nice one, Depp. Cult can't train those judges at the Fang Center anymore. Fowler Brothers is gonna be happy to get those grounds back. Might be worth asking around to see where that bear cheeseburger ran off to. Heard he's out there tearing up cult.
Whole place has gone to hell.
I'm just glad to see it out of the cult's hands, training those wolves to cause hell. And they've been shipping those crazy wolves all the way to the old lumber mill to keep an eye on prisoners. Now, we had a bear here named Cheeseburger. Bit of a local celebrity, actually. Had a soft spot for Chad's barbecue. But he got the diabetes, so we put him on a liquid salmon diet. Anywho, cult tried to take him, so I set him free. Last I heard, he was causing all sorts of mayhem. Someone should go find him, make sure he's all right. Grab some salmon from the pond ahead of time, though. Then feed Cheeseburger that salmon, and he'll be eating out of the palm of your hand. Keep killing them cult freaks.
You like that?
You're a hero in the North.
Thank you.
nothing. Just get right up in there and give him the salmon. Cuddly little guy will eat it right out of your hand, don't you worry.
Montana like me. Got a new job for you. Do you know what gerrymandering is? Of course you don't. You're a regular American, just like me. It's boring egghead stuff involving redrawn voting districts, blah, blah, blah. Anyways, the election's coming up, and them eggheads tell me I'm fucked in the polls because those goddamn Peggies ain't gonna be voting for me. Say what you will about lunatic cult movements, but the bottom line is, they vote. Now, the eggheads say the only chance I got at winning would be to go back in time and gerrymander them district lines so the Peggies ain't counted. And that got me to thinking, I could just as easily win if them Peggies just didn't show up to vote. Now, I'm not telling you how to go about such a thing, wink, wink, but a permanent solution to my temporary problem would work best, if you catch my meaning. Obviously, I'm not saying to murder anyone, because that's still illegal. It is still technically illegal, right? But if there were less Peggies around because they somehow tripped and fell on several dozens of bullets, it would probably help my chances. The district in question is up at the crossroads by the Grill Street Diner. You can take my idiot son with you. He's not good at much, but he can shoot okay. And you know, if this were ever to blow back on us, it would be good to have a patsy. I don't even think he'd get jail time on account of him being a little touched. Well, what you waiting for? Get moving.
Boy. It's gonna take a lot of work to clean that place up.
Hey, guy. Still standing at me.
Hello, lady.
Hey, you! Buddy!
Thank you.
vehicles?
One of you will be strong. Not again.
Yeah, your peaches.
I know you are in pain. The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh, huh? You're not the only one to be tested. Did you know that I had a wife? So beautiful, isn't she? We were pregnant with our first child. And we were just babies ourselves, really. And I was terrified of becoming a father, mostly about money. She wasn't worried. She had faith that things were gonna work out. She always had faith. And one day she was gonna go visit a friend. There was an accident. The Lord take him. They rushed him to a hospital and put me in a room with this little pink bundle stuffed with tubes. And they said that I had to be strong because my little girl was gonna live. God was looking out for our daughter. And they left me alone in the room with her. I just stared at my daughter. So helpless, so innocent. When all she had in the world was me. When nobody from nowhere with nothing. And in that moment, I knew that God was testing me. He was laying out a path before me, and all I had to do was choose. So I put my hand on my little girl's head. And I leaned in and I could smell. And we prayed together. Prayed for wisdom. Prayed for strength. And I knew. I heard God's plan for me. So I took my fingers and I put them on that little plastic tube that was taped. Angelic face, and I pinched it shut. And after a little while, her legs began to kick and kick. And then nothing. Stillness. Release. The Lord giveth, and the Lord. Sacrifice. These are all part of his test. When we have to prove that we can serve God, no matter what he asks. You've done well.
seen you in a while. Whitetails could really use your help out there. Pop by the wolf stand if you get the chance. We got a lot of work to do.
All clear. Reed is gonna be happy. Can't say the same for people who don't share his taste in music. Maybe we can work on this whole trust thing after all. Got more work for you back at the Wolf's Den if you're looking to keep busy. See you around.
Deputy, glad you're back. Got a job for you.
You remember the Grand View Hotel? That shithole we pulled you out of?
Need you to head back there.
Jacob nabbed a whitetail by the name of Briggs, and he's using the same brain-melting nonsense he tried on you. All in the hopes that Briggs will give up the Wolf's Den. I don't think our boy can hold out as long as you did. And if he gives up our location, we're done. So we gotta move on this quick. Some folks here think the smart move would be just to off them. But if we start killing our own to save our asses, how's that make us any better than Jacob? Nah, I ain't going down that road. Here's what we're gonna do instead. Weedy's cooked up a little deprogramming package. Same thing we used on you. Need you to swap out the tape they got running in Briggs' room with the one I'm gonna give you. And then, well, then we'll see what happens. If everything goes smooth, our guy comes back to Earth. If it doesn't, well, we'll deal with that when the time comes.
This is what Montana should look like every day.
Wasn't sure you'd come back, but I guess you're full of surprises. This squealer here ran security up at the chalet. Lucky for us, he wasn't that good at his job and wound up in my kiddie pool. Seems the place is being used as a training ground for the Chosen. If you've seen them in action, you know how ruthless they are. You know what Jacob taught them to use for target practice? Live bodies. Gets their first kill jitters out of the way. These motherfuckers don't value any life that ain't in their cult. And they need to be put down like the dogs they are. So you're gonna head up to that chalet. You're gonna kill every Chosen you see, and you're gonna rig that building with explosives. And then we're gonna watch that whole fucking place turn into a smoldering heap of ash. Sound good to you?
Took down my first deer.
I have to clean my rifle every day.
Shot north of there. Get moving.
stores in the area. Place is a goddamn fortress.
We must look to our past when life was simple and hard. Basic survival. That's when we were at our best. You see, the world has become soft, weak. We have sheltered ourselves from every obstacle, danger, and fear. We no longer hunt for our food, search for our water, or make fire. We're no longer hungry, thirsty, or cold. We're no longer alive. The solution is war. War will bring out our best. War will bring us life. Technology hasn't improved us, it's brought us to our knees. If our ancestors could see us now, they would be ashamed. They would be sickened, and they would be angry. We have forgotten where we came from. We have forgotten who we are. No longer. We will become killers. We will become tenacious. We will become strong. We must look to our past when life was simple and hard. Basic survival. That's when we were at our best. You see, the world has become soft, weak. We have sheltered ourselves from every obstacle, danger, and fear.
Now why are we trained?
We no longer hunt for our food, search for our water, or make fire. We're no longer hungry, thirsty, or cold. We're no longer alive. The solution is war. War will bring out our best. War will bring us life.
No! Not good enough! Again!
Damn skeeters are eating me alive today. I wonder what type
of... The father demands your devotion! We are only as strong as our weakest member!
Are you ready to defend Eden's Gate? Are you?
Ancient men were killers. They were tenacious. They were strong. Now what are we? Passive. Lazy.
Move! Move! Are you ready to defend Eden's Gate? Are you?
Culture and technology hasn't improved us. It's brought us to our knees. If our ancestors could see us now, they would be ashamed. They would be sickened. And they would be angry. We have forgotten where we came from. We have forgotten who we are. No longer. We will become killers. We will become tenacious. We will become strong. We must look to our past when life was simple and hard. Basic survival. That's when we were at our best. You see, the world has become soft, weak. We have sheltered ourselves from every obstacle, danger, and fear.
The father demands your devotion!
We no longer hunt for our food, search for our water, or make fire. We're no longer hungry, thirsty, or cold. We're no longer alive. The solution is war. War will bring out our best. War will bring us life. Ancient men were killers. They were tenacious. They were strong. Now what are we?
I'm good enough.
Passive.
I'm strong.
Lazy.
Enough, and people
weak.
Fear me.
Hey! Let's move!
Culture and technology hasn't improved us. It's brought us to our knees. If our ancestors could see us now, they would be ashamed. They would be sickened. And they would be angry. We have forgotten where we came from.
Now!
We have forgotten who we are. No longer. We will become killers. We will become tenacious. We will become strong. We must look to our past when life was simple and hard. Basic survival. That's when we were at our best. You see, the world has become soft, weak. We have sheltered ourselves from every obstacle, danger, and danger. We no longer hunt for our food, search for our water, or make fire. We're no longer hungry, thirsty, or cold. We're no longer alive. The solution is war. War will bring out our best. War. Culture and technology hasn't improved us. It's brought us to our knees. If our ancestors could see us now, they would be ashamed. They would be sickened, and they would be angry. We have forgotten where we came from. We have forgotten who we are. No longer. We will become killers. We will become tenacious. We will become strong. We must look to our past when life was simple and hard. Basic survival. That's when we were at our best. You see, the world has become soft, weak. We have sheltered ourselves from every obstacle, danger, and fear. No longer hunt for our food, search for our water, or make fire. We're no longer hungry, thirsty, or cold. We're no longer alive. The solution is war. War will bring out our best. War will bring us life.
Looks like he got 'em. Set the charges and finish this with fireworks. Weedy put a little extra kick in them, so enjoy the show.
Passive. Lazy. Weak. weak. Culture and technology hasn't improved us, it's brought us to our knees. If our ancestors could see us now, they would be ashamed. They would be sickened, and they would be angry. We have...
Bombs are set. Get out of there.
We are. No longer. We will become killers. We will become tenacious.
Five. Four, three, two, one.
You must be hungry. Yeah. Did you know it takes 10 days for civilization to collapse?
Yeah. You take away a man's basic needs and he will revert to his primordial instincts in just 10 days. That's a difficult thing to understand unless you've lived it. I was in Iraq during the first Gulf War. 82nd Airborne All-Americans, hoorah!
One night there was an ambush, and me and this guy named Miller got separated from the unit. No food, no radio. Nearest base, 200 clicks to the south, so we just started walking. Well, by the third day, I knew we were lost. Day six, ran out of water. You know what that's like, don't you? Difficult to swallow. On the seventh day, Miller's legs started going all wonky. Did you know your brain starts to eat your muscles in order to survive? That's why you're so goddamn skinny. And by the eighth day, the wolves were closing in. And I looked at Miller and I could tell we were as good as dead. And I accepted that. And in that acceptance came clarity. You see, I wasn't just looking at Miller. I was looking at an opportunity. It wasn't something I wanted. It was something that I had to do. It was my test. You see, Miller's sacrifice wasn't about me walking out of that desert. It was about bringing me here. The weak have their purpose. You'll understand that soon enough.
Well done. Yes, sacrifice the weak. That's it.
Strong enough. You have to get out of here before it starts again. Follow me. Second nature routine. It gets in your head. And you don't even realize it. You can't ever go back. You understand? You can't ever go back. Come on. Truck. That truck's gotta be there. Gotta get on the truck. It's almost time. I've studied the route for weeks. It's the only way out. You'll be safe if you don't. Not yet! Oh, fuck! Fuck! No! 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 Sorry.
Streak used to be. They've got something up on the screen there you've got to see.